Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. SliceOnBroadway.com, IndieWrestling.us. Check out IWC, RWA, and more. Click the Fight TV link on WrestlingMayhemShow.com to support this show and watch pro wrestling, MMA, boxing, and so much more. And listeners like you, support this show at Patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show. Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitter in the Mayhem Studios here in Pittsburgh, PA. Ready to talk about professional wrestling for the 561st Tuesday. Not quite in a row, but still, there's a lot of them. With me, as usual-ish, is... which show am I doing? It's Mad Mike in Poughkeepsie, New York, joining us.
I'm pretty sure there are a couple Wednesdays in there, Sorg.
There are some Wednesdays, and actually next week's going to be a Wednesday. Because of scheduling.
There might have even been a Sunday. Didn't we do the Mayhem Show from my house on a Sunday?
That might be too. So, heads up there. We actually will not be doing a live show on Tuesday next week because SmackDown's coming to town, and SmackDown's awesome, so we're going to it. So,
and to compensate for that, we're going to have a special guest next week.
Yes, we are. Absolutely. Special guest. So look special out guest. For that. And of course, it wouldn't be a Tuesday without people on the couch. Look at that OG over there. If you're on the video, Chad the Shad, the OG Mayhemmer, back on the show.
Hello, my people.
I need to turn your mic up.
Hello, my people.
I think your mic needs to be closer too. We'll work on that.
Hello, my people.
There you are. There you are. We found you.
Hello.
We found. Love the mic. Love the mic. The mic is your friend. The mic is your friend. I know it's been a while. I know they're bigger mics than what we used to use.
For those with the benefit of flash photography.
Yes, exactly.
Speak for yourself, sir. I'm a smaller mic than
good?
What we used
to use. Good? That's true. Yeah, it's good. That's good.
Right. Oh, God.
Oh, no, don't do that. Don't do that. How you doing?
Good. Great. Hall of Fame life is treating me well.
Yes, excellent. And we have a friend over there that we'll reference a little bit later for you. I know. He's back. Oh, no, he's flipping him off. He's flipping off Ultimate XDL right now. But we'll get to a little bit more of that in a minute. Also with us on the couch, he's back this week. Mutilator Larry is with us.
Hi.
And he's been giving us the updates on the 205 Live, the non-spoilery stuff. Austin Aries is amazing, and Noam Dar.
And Noam Dar is
Hashtag Neville Level.
Hashtag Neville Level.
Fantastic. Can't wait to watch that after the show here. And then, of course, over in the production booth, creepily followed by Hulk Hogan and a monkey, his wife of the show, Missy. That shot.
Why am I here?
What you got over your shoulder? It's just Hulk Hogan with the monkey.
He's like a thought bubble.
It's like
okay,
it's like
Hogan would never be my thought bubble.
It's like he's your grand idea,
brother.
That sounds like an awkward Brazilian soda commercial.
If Hulk Hogan is ever my brilliant thought bubble, just take me out. Just
we're done. You want to
Missy?
Drop,
what if you're thinking of who to murder?
Oh!
Actually, that could be accurate. Never mind.
Yeah. Oh.
Thanks, Mike.
You're welcome.
Sorg, just remember all the fun things that you've done.
Okay. Moving on is the Wrestling Mayhem Show. and that's the wrong part of my notes. You can follow the show. You can subscribe and to the show, comment, subscribe, leave a review over on the iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, or the video versions on the YouTube or Facebook page. And of course, we're here live every Tuesday, live.wrestlingmayhemshow.com, except for next Tuesday, of course, but that'll be on Wednesday, of course. Please join us there. We are on the Facebook Live, just like our friends Billy, Wheelz, Matt, and others are dropping in throughout the night. Thank you so much for joining us here live on the show and becoming part of it as well. we should be doing the show from the parking lot tailgating after SmackDown. You know, maybe...
I thought you guys tried that once.
We sort of did, and I don't think it worked out too well. Like kind of a remote version, didn't we try one time?
I thought it was from like a non-sponsored pizza place.
Did we try to record at Pizza Milano one time?
Yeah, it was a non-denominational pizza joint.
Non-denominational pizza joint.
How do you remember this more than I do?
Because Sorg, I have an excellent memory.
I've signed too many autographs.
I believe that was Wrestling Mayhem Show episode number 353. It's not. I just
somebody Google Wrestling Mayhem Show 353 and see what actually happened. But anyway,
if that's the same one, I will literally shit myself.
I literally don't even remember that happening.
If you did it, I don't think you did it with me.
No. I don't think that was the Chad the Chad era, no, for sure.
No.
Like you were ducked out by the 200s, I thought, right?
I think you were growing a return beard at that point.
Yeah. I don't know what the hell I'm growing a return beard for. I don't know what I'm returning to. But
The Wyatt family?
Yeah. Is that what's happening?
Run.
I hear there's a few openings.
There's a couple openings. Openings,
the Wyatt
for...
family is pretty much just a tree with no branches at this point, isn't it?
It kind of is, right?
It's a fucking stick.
They're open for new real estate opportunities. They have a wonderful plot of land, slightly used, no digging, it works. But,
hey, always remember, after a good raising, the forest always grows back denser, so...
Could make a nice...
Burn it all down and ends up growing back better than it was before.
So it could be a nice dog park?
It's a house. You know, don't... Dandelions.
You don't know what's buried.
Will there be a memorial statue for the two cameramen inside?
Maybe Sister Abigail will rise like a phoenix.
Plot twist.
I have to finish the
maybe
intro.
Maybe Randy was just using a phoenix down, and it just got way out of hand.
This is bringing me back, Missy. This is definitely bringing me back.
Producer hat.
Yes. What are we doing? Oh, please email us at the address.
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or 412-206-WMS0. Hit us up on the social media, Twitter at Mayhem Show. Of course, Wrestling Mayhem Show page, where we do the live streams, and Wrestling Mayhem Show group, where there's a lot of discussion, the Facebook group going on there, and my iPad just went away. Also, this is the hard part where I needed it too. Also, thank you to our Patreon supporters that have been contributing to the show at multiple levels, including the Pocky Club, where you guys get the Mayhem Show gold and all of that. And thanks to our friends over there, of course, a longtime Patreon supporter, Bo Diggity! Woo! As well as Ed Burke, the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment. And the rest of the list is Burr. I mentioned, there it is, Tragar, Bobby FJ Town, and of course at the Pocket Club $5 level, Tina Keys, Christopher Bishop, and Mad Mike just joined us, so he can get into the Patreon and the bank for the Mayhem Mania.
Sorg,
yes.
Sorg, one of the perks that you get for being a Patreon is you have to announce me any way I demand while I'm a Patreon, right?
That's kind of the deal. Mm-hmm. We give Bo Diggity and everything, sure.
Okay. You will henceforth refer to me as the American Kevin Owens.
Ladies and gentlemen, the American Kevin Owens, Mad Mike. He's wearing shorts.
Yes, I am. I am actually wearing shorts.
What's with this guy? That was just
who's wearing shorts?
Yeah. you gotta watch the Raw wrap-up.
We're continuing a gimmick.
Yeah, we're continuing something, an inside joke we started on the Raw wrap-up last night. So check out the Raw wrap-up.
It's like when South Park decided to do like a fluid storyline. We're actually running that through now.
Absolutely. the one time, and maybe we'll actually graduate the fourth grade. So with that, let's get into the topics of the show. Of course, WWE Fastlane happened, or as we were discussing here in the studio before, Sunday Night Raw. Which really did feel like it. Like, I know we've kind of like, oh, I don't know, there's this promo, I feel like I'm watching Raw or something. Like, no, I felt like I was watching Raw on Sunday night.
It was WWE slow, please, kids are at play. It wasn't Fastlane.
No.
It was like every once in a while the lights come on, you gotta go 15.
But yeah, this is yeah. school zone. It, yeah. It was totally school zone.
It was a walk to the bathroom in the middle of the night.
What?
That's how fast.
Are you
it was.
Describing the main event match?
No. That I don't know what the hell that
there
was.
There was a lot of walking in that.
There was. You're right. Kevin Owens was getting
I hope Kevin Owens was at least wearing his Fitbit. To get something out of that.
In my mind, he was wearing one of the Pokemon tractors catching some Pikachus.
Catching those Pikachus in the party hat.
Yeah, the Pikachus in the party hat. I mean, that is some real stuff there. A lot of them there in Milwaukee? Milwaukee?
I think it was Milwaukee.
Milwaukee. Raw, what are you doing, Raw? We went a half hour on this last night on the wrap-up. Of course, I'd say about 15 minutes of that is actually talking about Raw, and then the other times we're talking about Jerry Lawler being a dirty man, but still, like what?
I
you know, it is the cornerstone. There is a lot of other wrestling out there, and in contrast, we have SmackDown burning houses down and almost killing people with forklifts. Which, as somebody who edited several forklift safety videos, and thank you, I think Bobby F. J-Town for sharing the German forklift safety video on Twitter tonight, so please go check out Bobby FJ Town on Twitter for that. SmackDown gives no fucks right now.
Zero.
It's like they're just like
one bit.
I don't know, like, what I love to know the structure of what they're doing creatively, because we know the stories back in the day of how they did separate and kind of pit them against each other. Wow, it's working. And once again, like, I want to know who the Paul Heyman of this era is that is constructing what we're seeing on Tuesday nights now.
Yeah.
I'd say it's half working.
You say it's half working. What are you saying, Larry? Road Dogg with a dartboard.
Road Dogg's actually watching Mayhem Mania. It's just like, that's not a bad idea. I mean, tweak it. You know, so we don't get sued.
Maybe we're inspiring, you know? Yeah, okay, yeah. We're going to sue them. We're going to sue WWE for taking our
Sorg,
idea.
Sorg, do it. Aren't we?
Do it.
Producer, aren't we?
What are we doing?
Suing WWE for stealing our ideas.
Need legal consultation.
No, we know you're not actual legal consultation. That would be...
Yeah, that's something that I can't really speak to since I'm not a lawyer.
If you were hypothetically a lawyer, would you hypothetically let us sue the WWE for stealing our ideas?
I would hypothetically say that if we were going to sue the WWE, they would counterclaim and we would wind up with our pants proverbially caught down. So I don't think it'd be a good idea.
Obviously, at this point...
Nuts to them, I'm not wearing pants!
As a podcast prediction, podcast tradition goes...
You're a step ahead already, Mike.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, obviously, we need to call Hulk Hogan's friend Peter Thiel and see if he can fund our case.
Yeah.
It's a work for him.
Mayhem
got good money. What are we doing right now?
Going back to SmackDown.
Please!
I like how all the ideas are working, but they always make it look like Shane and Daniel Bryan have no idea what's happening. They're like in the after show, just like, guess we're gonna have to fix this. I don't know where we're going.
I think they actually don't know.
Yeah,
I don't think they read.
Like the writers aren't filling them in.
No, they. Yeah.
Like in comparison on Raw, it's Stephanie ordering Mick around, and they're making matches in the ring, and then Daniel Bryan and Shane just kind of like, oh, I hope something happens tonight. They don't seem to
they're kind of failing upwards.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
So anyway, there's a little bit of, like, I always wondered about that with you know, special Daniel Bryan and stuff, because obviously I don't think Daniel Bryan is like directly involved in creative, right? He's just there playing his role, I think. And you know, you can tell, like, I feel a little bit of he's dancing around. I don't want to say something in a certain direction. They have whatever Cliff's notes they have about the direction they're going, probably. And you see him dancing around as Renee is throwing stuff at him.
Yeah.
Right. Which is slightly awkward, but still like authentic at the same time.
It's very like wrestler A comes on the show,
yeah,
and yells at Bryan and McMahon,
Yeah.
And they're just like, I'm not even supposed to be here. Like, I just work here.
Yeah.
Why are you yelling at me? You know, The Miz or AJ Styles or someone's like, you got to fix this. Like, it's not my department. Why do you keep coming here?
I don't know where this dropped in, but Billy's in the chat room asking if it means that we're going to be backstage next Tuesday to write the show. Which,
they really
man,
need
if
that,
only.
They don't need that much help on Tuesdays.
No, they don't. They
just
really
the producer.
Don't. Yeah, yeah. Just the producer over there to give some advice and legal.
Show and, do Talking Smack.
Yes, and Talking Smack.
My favorite thing about Talking Smack is when Brian says something he's not supposed to, and he just spends the next 20 seconds being really quiet while he's like someone's yelling in his ear.
Yeah.
Like you can just tell he's getting reamed out.
You're like, no, you shouldn't say that. Like that one time he dropped the Trump comment, and I'm sure, I think he even commented the next week about, yeah, I got in trouble for talking about Trump last week. You know, like,
I thought he even said
like he's
DNA once.
He's accepted a return that not hit goes to his store.
Yeah.
You know? Oh, we got to put this out on the show. Guys. Yeah, sorry about that.
But that was we're at this point. Like SmackDown is so good that we love the talk show about SmackDown.
They incorporated it into the storylines.
Yes,
which is something they didn't do with Raw.
Which again, and we talked about this on the wrap up last night. Like that, it's the full breadth of how what is wrong with one versus the other is. We didn't even get through the Raw talk. We like it started. And we listened to the first like person and a half, and we're like, "This is not exciting."
What were they talking about?
I don't know. I don't know. Bayley and Sasha were gushing over being buddies or something like that. Yeah. And again, it's like, you know, Renee's on both of them. So yeah.
What's
you know,
it called?
It's because the
Raw talk.
Raw talk. I thought it'd be called like Raw Dogging or something.
with Jerry Lawler on there,
that'd be funny. Raw Dogging with Renee and JR.
JR?
Oh. That'll Lawler. Make you watch, right? No. You just say JR and everybody, oh, JR's back. Instant people tune in. And then they see Lawler. Disappointment. A roller coaster of emotions. That's
all
what you want. That's all, what you want. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Your face just ages 5 years just from tuning like, in.
Fuck.
Yeah, you get wrinkles and crow's feet. Like,
it's the singlet of Dorian Gray.
Yeah. It's Hulk Hogan.
Wow.
Mustache of Hollywood Hogan.
I hear a bandana handlebar mustache take off 10 years though.
What?
You wear a bandana, handlebar mustache, you like it takes 10 years off your face.
Yeah, yeah. You look nothing shy of like 45 at that point.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
The sunglasses help too.
The sunglasses, yeah, there it is.
Basically cover as much of your fucking face as possible.
Yeah, exactly.
Black out everything.
Wear the bandana. You know, he really got the idea from Macho Man. Because Macho Man wore the glasses and the headband as long as he could in the match. And I remember like Jesse Ventura or somebody like or maybe Gorilla Monsoon probably more likely, you know, saying he's gonna lose an eye when somebody smashes those glasses or something. I'm like, come on, he's fighting Coco Beware. Coco ain't getting no offense in. Let's be honest about this.
Hall of Famer Coco Beware.
I love me some Coco Beware, but Coco Beware was not getting some glasses offense in on this. What? I'm getting a look. Did I offend your sensibilities about Coco Beware?
No, I was going to ask if I could get some Coco Beware with marshmallows.
Oh. Okay. On that note,
only if they're bird shaped marshmallows.
That would be great, wouldn't it? I mean, we should like some good throwback cereals or something like that. That'd be tremendous.
Junkyard dogs.
Junkyard dog bones.
Yes.
Hmm. Yeah. Hmm. Monetization, man. I mean, for such a marketing machine that it is, it just feels like there's so much missing in the meantime.
Boogeyman worms.
Well, let me give a shout out to something.
Boogeyman fish and bait.
Something that is not missing, and that is the pizza we feed the people that get here in studio. That's how we get so many. We've been attracting them. Some of the kids in the neighborhood, we tell them to go away because we have our buddies from Slice on Broadway right here in Beachview. If you're in the area, Beachview, PA, right along the tracks here, as well as Carnegie, PA, down on Main Street, and PNC Park, home of the Pittsburgh Pirates. They've been supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza for a good while now. We really do appreciate it, and sometimes we take them cookies. So Thank you so much to the guys for supporting the show. If you're in the Pittsburgh area, you got three choices there. Go check it out. If you're not in the Pittsburgh area, one, tweet them and say, man, they need to stop talking about it on that Mayhem show. I want some. Or in the meantime, please support your local pizza establishment and support independent wrestling, support independent pizza as well, please. I don't care what Domino's says about renovating their stores. The pizza is still Domino's, which means is French for cardboard.
There's a really good indie pizza place in Poughkeepsie.
Oh yeah. Really okay. Good. Wait. They don't sponsor the show. So moving on.
I know they don't, but I'm just saying I've eaten their pizza for as long as I have lived, and as you can tell, I am a man who enjoys pizza.
We're not.
I am the American Kevin Owens.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Despite being closer to Canada than the rest of us here, you absolutely are. And we're not just supporting the a local establishment. We're supporting an idea.
Yes.
What's in the cup?
But what are you talking about?
But the idea of supporting independent pizza. Now let's talk about wrestling. SliceOnBroadway.com. Best dad ever.
Wrestling.
Hardy boys. I don't think anybody here had the opportunity, of course, to see Ring of Honor, unfortunately.
We missed the window to book them last week.
We missed the window. The 3 day
closed. Now.
Wait, it's closed. They're in Ring of Honor.
They're signed. They were not signed last week.
We have had signed Ring of Honor people on the show.
Are they signed with Ring of Honor?
Within the last couple weeks or months, actually.
On Mayhem Mania?
Oh,
I'm talking about Mania.
Oh, I thought you were talking about having them on the show.
Oh no! I'm sure Matt and Jeff will teleport into the Mayhem Studios to get the what was the championship at Sorg Stock?
what were the
tag team championships at Sorg Stock?
Pirate Ship Championship.
Oh, the Pirate Ship Championship. That's around.
There
somewhere.
You go. Eventually, Vanguard 1 will teleport into the Mayhem Studio and say, where are your tag team champions?
I apologize, Mad Mike's getting a little glitchy there. But I don't know what it is, Mike. I'm sorry.
I guess the weekly features will have to show up.
Oh, then. There you go.
That's about the closest thing to an official Mayhem show only tag team. We haven't been officiated with anybody else. We're the homegrown Mayhem show.
But still, Ring of Honor, we have the Hardys there. One Hardy back, I guess. I mean, it's still kind of, it kind of blew my mind the first time, but it was like, Jeff Hardy is in Ring of Honor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's there.
He's along for a ride, maybe a little bit, but yeah. Sure. Okay. I can't wait to get the opportunity to watch that match. I just saw, we'll talk about a place where you can get that match actually here soon. And it's like, it's a high consideration, I think. If I get time. And on top of that, they also had Bubba Ray Dudley pop up in Ring of Honor at this was the not the 15th anniversary. It was Manhattan Mayhem, and so Ring of Honor is getting
Bubba Ray being there is exciting.
Yeah, it is. Well, tell me about that, Mike.
I want to see a segment with him in Dalton Castle.
Oh yes. Oh jeez.
I just want to see that. Like, if that ever happens on Ring of Honor TV, I will watch that week. I will categorically watch that week because I just want to see that interaction. I need to see that.
Mm-hmm.
Like I want Bubba Ray to powerbomb Dalton Castle through the chair that the boys have made.
And this confused me because I thought the Dudleys were sticking around as agents for a bit.
I think D-Von is.
It's just D-Von?
D-Von is for sure.
Okay. So it's just kind of a okay. Well, that makes sense.
Yeah, D-Von's there. He's on Raw, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if they stay.
Yeah.
I don't know if they dabble both.
Bubba also showed up last year at House of Hardcore here in Pittsburgh as a surprise entrant as well, or surprise show up, I guess, as well, and almost put Ray Lynn through a table. So
Sorg, what do you think the likelihood of Velvet Sky showing up in Ring of Honor is?
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Well, I think you're going to see... I think you're going to see Ring of Honor...
I would love to see a battle of the skies, Velvet versus Remy. I mean, granted, she's pregnant right now, so that can't really happen.
Yeah, not anytime soon, I guess, but no. But yeah, I mean, really, it is time. I mean, it was already happening with WWE... with NXT, obviously, and we're seeing how that's going. Look at Austin Aries now. 205 Live tonight and last night on Raw. I mean, I'm getting a look from Larry on how great that was. Still, it's, you know, Impact is leaking people. And obviously, they're putting their promos for their kind of revamp, which I think is happening this week, Mike.
Yeah.
So
yeah, it is
what it is.
We are going to see, because I still want them to succeed.
We all want them to succeed, but the pieces in place don't really scream big change, right?
No, and not at all.
And even some conversations I was having some people today that were close to the matter.
I wonder who that could be, Sork.
You just look at Indie Mayhem Show for the next 2 weeks. It's more than that, you know. It's looking at some of the things and the people in charge, and you don't see even a direction coming out of the gate, right? You don't see, you know, the biggest thing is, and we know this is in their advertising right now, is Alberto Patron. Is he going by Patron this time?
El Patron
on this one. So he's in yet another promotion. Okay, sure. Which means Paige may show up after she finally drops her WWE contract.
Oh, that's not going to happen.
No? Are they locking her up?
Paige is going to be locked up until The Rock's movie comes out about her at the very least.
Oh, yeah.
The very least. Because they film part of that movie during a WWE event.
Yeah.
You think Paige is going to be on a different show to promote that? Fuck no.
Or is, and just, yeah, that gets a little awkward at that point. But who knows what's going on with that story. So, I don't know, it's some interesting moves with our number two and four promotions, I guess you could say.
Wait, which one's two, which one's four?
I'm going ROH.
Let's clarify this.
I'm going ROH. Seriously, I am going ROH is the number two. Only
I'll say they're number three.
I mean I know they're number three in our hearts, Matt. Mike, why don't I want to call you Matt tonight? Matt Mike. Just completely confuse it, but still, like, I think realistically, amongst scope, Ring of Honor would be a number two. And that's nothing against a Lucha Underground, but Lucha Underground is limited TV / Netflix. It was great to hear Lucha Underground brought up on Cord Killers, by the way, by Isaac Tar that Matt Carlins has brought up, who always wears like Seth Rollins shirts whenever he's doing his Cena tech stuff. He does like a little Netflix preview and brought up Lucha Underground. So that was
nice.
Exciting on Cord Killers today. Obviously I think Ring of Honor just has more scope and is out there a bit more. Relationships with Ring of Honor, with New Japan Wrestling, you know, it just seems.
No, I know what you mean. I'm just busting chops on.
Hell, I just wanted to
make sure we all agreed Impact was fourth.
let's be honest. Yes,
I
absolutely.
Just wanted to make sure.
I would like to know how I am not on the show on a regular basis, and TNA is still in the same position. And you guys are having the same conversation about TNA.
Even though, and
every time I come back,
they limp. You know, we don't talk about Impact on this show every week.
But every time I'm on the show,
because,
which has been,
you know what,
years.
I wasn't going
it's
to.
It's the same story.
But we realized that we have an owl we named Ultimate X. Sitting right there beside you. We named him Ultimate X the Owl years ago. And you know what's happening with Impact Wrestling now, right?
It's the same thing that's happened to this owl. The slow deterioration.
And it looks a little
and
rough.
And effects of gravity.
But you realize, have you seen the recent logos
Yes.
For Impact Wrestling.
They're just grasping.
The owl looks better.
The owl. Well,
it looks Sorg, like Sorg, it looks like they sell thing. Like knockoff chicken tenders or frozen dinners. Like if I walk down the aisle to a supermarket, look, oh, let me get some of these Impact peas and carrots. Like that looks like a dried food logo.
You feel like it's Booker T with the Hunger Man commercials again, right?
Yeah, like a knockoff Bird's Eye.
They sell it at Aldi's. Like.
If you want some nutrients, try Impact Snow Peas. They should probably just switch. They might make some more money.
They might make money.
Impact
this week. When I live tweet Impact this week, every tweet will contain the hashtag Impact Snow Peas.
There you go.
Oh, that's great. Anyway, it gives you a different look at it. I mean, and every time, like, they're not getting better with their logos either. It is, and this is the slight graphic designer. I saw the new one.
What's the new one?
They went Jeb exclamation point on a Sorg.
Did they? Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on, is it on their site?
You pulled up?
It's Impact exclamation point.
Wait, seriously?
Yes, I'm not joking.
And they've officially... The slow death of the initials TNA have finally happened, right?
Except death, that it's still right on the front of their fucking championship.
Everywhere except for where it matters the most.
That's okay. And nobody watches it, so no one.
Jeez.
Knows.
And then here's the latest thing. Another thing I was talking with somebody about today. So Spike TV, they announced that they're going to be on Spike TV, but Spike TV's executive denies involvement with them.
They announced a potential talk with Spike TV, did they not?
They announced they're talking with Spike TV?
It's Spike TV with an exclamation point.
Oh, it's
totally different than the Spike TV that's you see on air.
I'm noticing a trend here a little bit.
Esquire Network.
I don't even know what channels there are.
Maybe they're just like, going to be on E.
Like literally, like point. If I end up at like my dad's place with DirecTV, like it's a whole new world to me because I haven't seen regular cable on a regular basis.
Right.
They're on the Golf Channel at 2 a.m.
What, Impact?
Yeah.
we remember Destination America. We had a lot of fun with that. Oh, here is
you know how cosmically awful wrestling is, Sorg.
What's that?
Sorg. Do you want to know how cosmically awful wrestling is sometimes?
What's that?
All right. How many different channels has Impact been on?
Why is it green?
This is at least the fourth.
Okay.
Yeah.
My cable provider has every fucking one of them. Guess how many times I've actually been able to watch Ring of Honor on my TV, Sorg?
Wait.
Twice.
Just guess.
Wait. I thought we were talking about Impact a moment ago, right?
No, I know. One? Yeah, no, but it's unfair, Sorg.
Yeah.
Ring of Honor has never been on my television.
Wow. Yeah, because
of the channels Ring of Honor has been on, it's never been on my cable provider yet. Every fucking time Impact moves from Fox Sports and Network to Spike TV to Destination America to. Whatever pop. The fuck, it's a pop it TV a pop? To fucking whatever is next. It's probably like Clue, C-L-O-O. That's probably where it's going next because they don't fucking have a clue.
Uncle Jeb's local accents. I still get accents. Those
channels. I mean, fair. You don't have comment. You don't have...
No!
Well, okay, that's okay. I will Mike, later in the show here in a few minutes, I'm going to show you the way to Ring of Honor.
I don't want to watch it on the internet.
There is an answer.
I can find it on the internet.
No. But you need to get a credit. You need to watch Jay Lethal's orthopedic knee brace commercial where he's yelling at you about his knee brace. You got to do it. You got to do the catheter cowboy commercial. You got to do all that stuff. It's the full Ring of Honor experience.
Sorg.
Just like you got to watch Raw with Enzo. Talking about having sex with Golden Chicken from KFC.
You shouldn't have to watch that.
No one should have to watch that.
Remember the first time, the long, awkward, like...
I guess you could say it's run afoul.
He's gonna fuck this chicken. And it's not even alive. I don't know if that makes it better or not.
It's golden.
It gets PETA off their backs.
To be fair, I've heard the golden barbecue sauce is a natural lubricant, so...
Oh, okay, 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 wow.
I read some weird food blogs, Sorg.
Don't try that with Nashville Hot.
I can't even recover from that. Oh, what was I going to do? Am I going to make fun of Drew Galloway again? Is that what I'm going to do right now? Do we need to move on?
Producer, help.
What?
Matt Carlins has shared what is this? A YouTube video.
What will happen Thursday night, March 9th on Impact Wrestling? Is this the thing with the owl?
I have not seen this.
I don't know, and all it says is enjoy.
Oh, I have not seen this. I'm watching it right now.
All right, it's going to take me a minute to pull this up. So maybe this is
the first thing it says. It's a fight for relevance. You're fucking right. It is TNA
in your frozen food aisle.
I'm right. It's a fight for relevance.
Yeah, just watch Elder promos for it and just imagine it is.
Oh
all
my
for
god, there's a fucking owl.
I believe Matt put a big screen cap of the owl. He's like, oh, this is going pretty good, and then suddenly.
Save it for gold.
We'll watch it live on gold here.
I just watched.
Okay,
it.
Okay. We'll get the rest of the reactions here in a moment.
The first thing it says is a fight for relevance, and TNA has never had more truer advertising in their fucking lives.
They are talking directly to us.
They're talking directly to me. I'm convinced that I'm the only person who watches this show anymore.
Well, yeah, their office is right across from your house, Mike.
You've been the only person watching it for years.
Shut up, Chad.
Years.
No. Remember, when I was in Nashville last year, I went and sought out the TNA offices.
Yeah.
I found their office.
Well, no, you found their sign.
I know
Garza
still watches TNA.
And I found the sign, and then I went to find, because it was when the news broke that their office was moving. And it was like out in the suburbs, and it was like I went to the address, and the GPS stopped me, and there was like an oil refinery in front of me, a Dollar General to the left, and then a shack at the address. It was just out in the middle. It's the Midwest, so it's, you know, everything's flat. Yeah. But still, it was kind of curious. So
using that TNA as a shell company is better use than what they're actually promoting.
They'd be a bad shell company too.
Yeah,
nobody is going to inspect it.
It's true. Wrestling, whatever.
Who's going to look it up?
Anyways, all right, guys. Well, speaking of all of this stuff, Ring of Honor, Mayhem Mania, dogs barking, mayhem, absolute chaos. But in the meantime, you know what you can do. We have a new affiliate friend with Fight TV. It's an app. It's if you guys haven't checked this out, I had heard about it for a while here, you can check it out. You know, a good affiliate to us. You can click the link over at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Download it there. You can watch wrestling for free, including Mike. Ring of Honor Television is on there, so you can check out that, including recent episodes. They just filmed here in Pittsburgh. Got to see 4 episodes filmed for all of that. So please go check that out. And also, I've been digging through it a little bit, kind of to catch up on things. First of all, you know, we talk about a lot of the stuff over at IndieWrestling.us, but a lot of the Prime Wrestling, our documentaries, including Finding Zach Gallen, is included on here, and you can rent or buy those to watch as well. But also free stuff like ICW Fight Club, ICW, one of the promotions that was really put over with the UK tournament when the WWE, they showed the promoters from it. Ring of Honor, including their 15th anniversary show, is on here. You can pick it up. If you are so inclined, you can check out some of the TNA stuff. They have, for instance, here's a replay of TNA Legends, World Title Matches 2. Some of their One Night Stand shows are up here. And if you're into boxing, striking, MMA, there's a lot of options there too. Not as familiar myself with that. Judo. You want some judo? Get at some judo. So go check it out. Also, you know, again, it's an easy way because I haven't really liked the Ring of Honor website for watching the show. It comes up later in the Thursday. These ones premiere Monday. And if I'm not mistaken, I think it's the Monday after they've like shown locally in the area. Like, you know, they're on like what, Saturday nights and Sunday nights here in the Pittsburgh market, for instance. They're different for everybody.
I catch them on at weird times.
Yeah.
And, like, it'll be so, I like flipping through a channel and I say, oh, RLH.
And they premiere Mondays at 7 p.m., which is kind of nice because then you can watch it before you go watch Raw. So, you know, nice palate cleanser before you go watch Raw, I guess. Right. So if you really want to get into something like that. But a good option. That. Also, Championship Wrestling from Florida, which a name just dropped on an interview I was doing today with somebody over there. And also, first one episode I watched, old friend of the show, Dylan Bostick, is a part of that because he moved out west and now he's a big part of the West Coast wrestling scene, including that. Please go check it out. It's Fight TV. You download the app, but please go over to WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Click the link there, our affiliate link, right on the right side of the page. You'll see a big Fight TV to support the show. You know, we're just rolling this out this week, so if you haven't downloaded the Fight TV app yet, or if you have, click the link. You know, let the people know, support. I want to show Fight TV the support of the Mayhem Nation here. So please go check that out, and we'll be talking about it here in coming weeks as well. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with a big question. Of course, you heard the dog going nuts because he's excited for Mayhem Mania with Matt Carlins. We'll see you in a moment.
Sidekick Media Services. We are your sidekick in business for social media, video production, and more. Find out more at sidekickmediaservices.com.
We're back. It's the Mayhem Show, and of course, we got Shad the Shad OG Mayhemmer. Mutilator Larry, he's done with the 205 Live for this week. Mad Mike from Poughkeepsie, New York.
Sorg. What's my full name?
American Kevin Owens.
Yes.
And also joining the show is the proprietor of Mayhem Mania. It is Mainstream Matt.
This card needs some work.
His voice
some work to do.
His voice is still recovering from his first PWX show this past weekend.
Well, the referees were incompetent, Sorg, and I needed to tell them every single minute of the entire show.
Especially the one that happened to be the heavyweight champion.
I know.
For his own match.
Watch those close fists.
Yeah, watch those close fists. Also with us is Hot Wheelz leading the way into Mayhem Mania. Yes.
So, what's up?
This is 1997.
Bringing the timely comedy.
Sorry, I saw the commercial on Facebook. My bad.
Oh no. But anyway,
don't feel bad. I'm wearing a Nexus T-shirt, so really, you're fine.
Yes, yes. That's all right. It's all right.
Miss
I'm wearing
every day, Wade.
I can't. You know, I gotta give a shout out to Hooven Ground, Dan Hooven, who I don't think we talked about. Did very well in his first official, actually got gear match. Except for that thing with his ankle.
If we're giving shout-outs, Sorg, I'm going to give a shout-out to the Southern Belle, Jesse Belle Smothers.
There you go.
Strong.
On her shirt.
Anybody else want some shout-outs? You want to give a shout-out to the PlayStation game over there?
I'm sporting my very nice zip-up PlayStation hoodie that I got on the West Coast at PSX 2016.
Nice. All right. Anybody else? Is that everybody? We all good? Okay. All right, but it is time for the big question, and Matt Carlins, you have something lined up?
Yeah, just something I thought about earlier today, and you guys need a question, so I'll come up with it. The topic being Enzo and Big Cass, just a very simple question, since they've been doing some interesting things lately. Is Enzo holding Big Cass back, or is he propping Big Cass up?
Oof.
Ooh. That's tough.
Depends on when he fucks that chicken.
Is that something we did on show or in gold? I can't remember anymore.
Georgia sounds like gold, but now it's out there.
You should have to pay for that. I can't remember. Somebody's going to have to pay for that. You know, I feel, I don't know if he actually is, but I can see the, you know, with them never winning the belts, like, I feel like they're framed for a cast getting tired of his shenanigans.
But they've done so far.
I know, but
he's put up with them for so long.
He has for maybe a little too long. I think storyline wise, it's creeping for the breakup a little bit. But so I think keep an eye out for that maybe at or after Mania. And talent wise, no, I think Enzo is what's given Cass more of an opportunity.
What is Big Cass without Enzo? He's big like and mean. Billy Gunn without the Road Dogg.
He's Test.
They gave him his two words to say.
Yeah.
Except Cash has one word to say. And I could see a very similar trajectory if they break up. I mean, for both of them, actually.
Cass is great, but he's not Enzo on the mic.
No.
Like, absolutely not.
But his size allows him to not have to be.
True. True. You know, but man, Braun Strowman has been a chatterbox lately.
But
he's magic on the mic.
Voice. He is magic on the mic.
Not everybody's got the shit
sounds like he's going to steal your soul with his voice. So versus the Jersey thing going with Cass. So I don't know if that really kind of helps him out there. So I don't. That's my thoughts. Last one's it. Anyway,
I think.
Go ahead.
I'm hoping that at least by SummerSlam, Cass puts Enzo through an announcer table and turns heel.
Through a plate glass window?
Or a plate glass window, or the Jumbotron.
Why is there all of a sudden a window on the set?
He could put him through the through the New Day's ice cream stand for all I care.
Enzo's small enough.
And then send Enzo down to 205 Live.
Oh, geez.
Hey,
oh, geez.
Here's my thought on it.
Stick your head in. Stick your head in. There you go. Get closer to that mic.
Here's my thought on it. I see Enzo as being the outspoken guy that he is, just having so much charisma and everything like that, and looking at Cass saying, "Dude, you're holding me back. You're killing my shine," and just seeing him walk away to do his own thing. I like the 205 Live. I like that aspect of things.
It needs a mouthpiece.
Absolutely.
There's
not many
talkers on 205 Live.
That would be the perfect mouthpiece for it.
Yeah.
I think
good.
If you were to do that, I think they could still remain a tag team. No one says you can't have single careers where you never fight each other and still be a tag team.
That's true.
It didn't really work for the Outlaws when they tried it, though.
I think they should have
cruiserweights or.
Yeah, but there was one WrestleMania where Billy Gunn was the IC champion, Road Dogg was the hardcore champion. It was very weird. It was very weird just to see that, because like their whole shtick relies on each other.
You have an entirely different pool of competition, though.
Yeah, and there's an entirely different show, so you have a different storylines within those different shows. Kind of like the Raw and SmackDown breakdown, like they're bringing them together for the Super Show stuff, and it works pretty well. You know, so I think that they could do a similar
kind of tied in. It's not going to be like Kane and Rey Mysterio.
Yeah.
Like, it's going to be, it would be Enzo, you fight cruiserweights. That's it. Cass, you fight heavyweights. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
You can tag team together and go for gold every once in a while. But.
I wonder.
That's
if
it. You'll never fight each other. Cass isn't going to go.
Yeah.
Dropping legs all over the cruiserweight division just because.
I foresee something a little different with Enzo and Cass.
Okay.
I think they're going to win the belts at Mania. And I think eventually they're going to hold it until a certain person from NXT is waiting to be called up, and that person will be called up as the impetus for their breakup. And Enzo is going to turn on Big Cass and join up with Liv Morgan.
Ooh.
That's what I'd do anyway, because then you could have Enzo be like a mouthpiece for her, and like Liv is the Lana to Enzo's Rusev.
Wasn't there a kind of a vibe like that whenever they wasn't there a vibe like that whenever Carmella first joined up with them? That like she was gonna cause them to break up? In NXT.
Maybe a little bit.
I think so.
But then they decided not to.
There's always that option.
Yeah.
You know?
It's the nuclear break glass relationship option.
In case of emergency break glass. Barbershop window.
Yeah, exactly. What about you, Wheelz?
I've been sitting here thinking, I mean, I could see them breaking up, but I could see Big Cass going on his own, but Enzo being like the manager on his own wrestling, but he's still got mouthpiece for Cass until Cass feels more comfortable being on the mic by himself type thing. Because honestly, I could see Cass being the Shawn Michaels of the two with his size and everything. So
He might even be good on the mic. It's just overshadowed by Enzo.
Well, yeah, too, Enzo
doesn't get a chance to talk that much.
Enzo was hurt, like he was kind of on his own for a little bit, and he was fine, but he
got a world title shot at that
point. He did. And he just needs time, really.
I think he could be a solid mid-card.
Yeah, mid-card big
performer,
guy.
You know, like Cesaro. Mm-hmm.
I'd love to see a US title feud between Cass and Strowman.
That could be fun. Oh, God. That could be fun. Both young guys, though, so I'd be curious to see how that goes. So, yeah, I like that.
I think I would prefer both of them to be heel.
Individually?
No, as a team.
Really?
Yeah, but that'll never happen because there's too many tag team heels.
And plus, they're too insane.
Unless
the crowd sours on them, that's not happening.
Yeah, but I think that's even the fun part is I think they would have more dynamic range as most heels do,
mm-hmm.
given Enzo's capabilities on the mic. It always seems like creatively they have a much better outlet when they're heels.
Yeah, absolutely. What you can do with it?
Because when you're a face, you can only say like I'm happy. Mm-hmm. So
that's good. Mike said, "Look at Neville. You're
yeah.
Geez, did you think Neville was going to be this good in that position?"
Yeah, the only thing you can't do is because there's too many heel tag teams,
right?
And you can't. There's no traction for them to really do anything.
Right.
You could send them to SmackDown.
Unless you change the landscape, but
that seems kind of piled too. So,
but
well, no, I mean you switch tag team because honestly, I think the big problem with Enzo and Cass and with New Day right now is that they're on the same show.
Yeah,
and they have similar shticks. So. True. We're kind of getting burned down, both of them. If you make Enzo and Cass a heel tag team and they attack like American Alpha, that'd be great.
Could you bring over?
And you could have that be like, hey, American Alpha, you never gave us a legit tag title shot in NXT.
I was just about to say that.
Yeah. Wait. What was this? I don't know if we got that.
Someone was asking which tag team do we bring over from SmackDown, and Larry said the Fashion Police, and I was like, jeez. Yeah.
You know how much fun you can have with those two,
especially
if there's like a celebrity on or something,
or especially if they go against Gallows and Anderson.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of fashion faux pas in those jackets of theirs.
All black, so played out.
You know what they need
leather,
to do?
Yeah,
I feel like they would get a huge boost if they did like. Just a segment like, you know, how Jericho does with like their interviews and stuff where they just do like a wrestler makeover type thing. Like where they're like, God. They're like trying to dress Braun Strowman and then he just demolishes them.
I can see them doing like,
you know what I mean?
You give them like a, like an online segment.
I want to see the Fashion Police give a makeover to the Titus brand.
Yeah. Oh. So it needs it. What was that, Matt?
I want to see the Fashion Police get like an online segment like the Miz and Morrison used to have.
Oh, and no, they don't do that anymore.
Red carpet.
All that online fun stuff went away, didn't it?
It went to the network.
Then make it part of the 3-hour Raw. It's not like you don't have time for it.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, Sorg. Sorg, do you know who did a lot of the dirt sheet stuff?
Legata?
Do you know who did? No, our special guest next week, Krista Joseph.
Oh,
yeah!
Getting your former WWE writer friend of the shows mixed up.
Yeah, yeah. And why is that important, there, Mike?
Well, that's going to be important because Lucha Underground's going to be on Netflix next Wednesday.
Woo!
So y'all bitches better binge and catch up.
I'm playing on it.
I got like 4 episodes left. I'm on this.
Sorg, what? All right, this is a mandate.
What?
Wrestling Mayhem Show mandate.
Oh, I thought
by the time.
Okay.
Oh, I thought we were going to do a thing.
I thought he was talking about the Fashion Police.
No.
Yeah, I thought he meant a mandate. This is a mandate.
One word, not two words. One word.
Oh, okay.
By the time Lucha Underground comes back at the end of May, everyone on this show has to be caught up.
I plan on being caught up.
Everyone.
Well, at least the 2 seasons, right?
Or you go on mandate.
Yes.
Or we have to go on a mandate to a taco restaurant.
Yes.
I think they air it at Taco Bell over in Greentree.
Would they air it?
Yeah.
Sure. They just renovate it. Why not?
Yeah, so,
just put it on loop. So, anyway,
that's how Dario Cueto got started. Before he made his millions and bought the wrestling promotion. He was running Taco Bell's
Taco Bell franchise.
That gets you there.
Yep.
Leads you to the proprietor of this Taco Bell.
Actually, I think out in California, it's Del Taco, not Taco Bell.
There's Del Taco out there. But, you know, I am here for the chalupas and violence. Anyways.
Wait. Would you like violence with that?
Wait.
Spicy violence?
We have a comment in the chat.
Do we?
In response to our question.
Yes. Brandon?
Yes.
Hello. I knew you'd come. Sorry.
So are you going to tell people what Brandon is saying?
No, I just wanted to say that. You can say the rest
of it. Wow. Brandon's chiming in. Sometimes Enzo is keeping back, but if you see in the matches, sometimes Cass is trying to give Enzo the spotlight.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, there's some sometimes commentary on that one.
Go.
Cass wants to let Enzo work the entire match, and that's why we spend 15 minutes watching him get his butt kicked.
He does very well.
It's hot 7-foot baby face fire.
It does help make him look like a bulldozer. Once he gets that tag, though.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I mean, tag wrestling 101, baby.
Enzo is very good at getting his ass beat.
It is time for the weekly WrestleMania thought experiment. Is this the third year we've done this?
Third year
we've done this. My God.
3 years of greatness.
Of greatness. It's 3 years of something. It is time for Mayhem Mania, and your proprietor of it, Main Street Matt.
This is Mayhem Mania.
It's
kind of a competitive thought experiment.
Sort of.
We are trying to build a better WrestleMania for you. We hear all of you complaining you don't like WrestleMania. You know WWE could do better if only had unlimited cash and zero self-control. They could make a fantastic WrestleMania card. So that's what we're doing. We're kind of showing what the possibilities are within the current reality. So everyone we're talking about is coming in their current physical, contractual, emotional, all of that state. We are working on a big 8-match card. Every week, 5 people join us, and they make 1 change to our card. Now, here's a little bit of a catch. If one of the matches on our card make it through 3 rounds, 3 weeks, without being changed or altered in any way, they get locked in, basically, and we stash them on our permanent super card where they don't have to worry about being changed anymore, and that opens a slot for more shenanigans and hurt feelings, which, of course, is hurt feelings is what Mayhem Mania is all about. Now, let me figure out what we're going to talk about first. Let's talk about the matches on the super card, Sorg.
Yeah. So
let's tell you which matches have already graduated. First of all, we've got American Alpha versus the Kings of Wrestling versus the Revival, created by Bobby F.J. Town.
Oh.
Very nicely done.
Very good. I like that a lot.
Brock Lesnar versus Kevin Owens, created by the IWC Rookie of the Year, Jackson Argus.
That's very good.
And just last week, we graduated The Shield versus The New Day, which was created by Mad Mike. Now, whenever a match graduates, the creator of the match gets to come back and collect a little bit of a reward. That's where the competitive part of the competitive thought experiment comes in. So Mike gets to...
Congratulations.
Mad Mike, do you hear me?
Yes.
Mad Mike, are you there? Great.
Yes.
Mad Mike, I want you to ponder what you're going to do, because coming up in just a couple minutes, you're going to create a match to fill our 8th empty slot now that was left by the match graduating.
I'm good at filling slots, Matt Carlin.
Yeah. You're going to get to eliminate or delete one wrestler from ever being used during this year's Mayhem Mania, which is always good. I'm sure you got an idea of that. And you're going to get to hand out a little bit of punishment. Sometimes I like to keep this under wraps, but Mad Mike, I want to let you know what the punishment is this week so you can properly distribute this to our players. Okay. This week's punishment, and I think you're going to like it, is the Wheel of 205 Live. We've got about 20 guys on it. It's the biggest wheel we've ever done.
Huge. Look at that
son of a bitch. We've got the Bollywood boys on this son of a bitch.
The Bollywood boys.
I don't even want to get started. They're all there. Just trust me.
Are the Bollywood boys on there separately or as a unit?
Separately to enhance the pain.
Okay. Harv and Gerv.
Yes, exactly. And to also increase the chances that they'll get picked. So anyway, this week's players, and this is going to be the order we go in. And this is all going to be after Mad Mike does his business. This week's players are going to be Sorg, then Missy, the wife of the show, then Larry, then Hot Wheels, and then batting cleanup will be Shad the Shad.
Of course.
Mad Mike, while you think about what you're going to do with your three moves, I'm going to run through the seven matches that are on the so-called undercard, at least the card that we can actually change. Sorgi, do you want to go to the... Hey! There we go. Samoa Joe versus Braun Strowman, the internet's favorite wrestler, Strowman Reigns, created by Hot Wheels. We also have... Oh, man, matches I'm going to have trouble explaining to Chad. Raven versus Bray Wyatt, created by Jackson Argos. He's just nodding. He's down with it. We've got AJ Styles versus Shinsuke Nakamura. Who created that?
Riz.
The Riz.
Yep.
We have Jack Gallagher versus Finn Balor, created by Sorgatron. Good job, buddy. We have a six-man tag. Bobby Roode, Austin Aries, and Eric Young versus Booker T, Scott Steiner, and Kurt Angle. That's right, the main event mafia. It's a TNA Dream match on WrestleMania, created by Tonio Garza from the Wrestling Revolution. Followed by that, we have...
Get applause for that one.
Slow clap for the TNA Dream match. God damn. Peyton Royce and Billy Kay versus Lay Cool, created by Mad Mike. And we have Charlotte versus Asuka, and that was created by Bobby F. J-Town. That's seven matches. We need eight. Mad Mike, would you do me a favor and create a match to fill the slot on my big board?
Well, since my grand plan of John Cena and Nikki Bella versus Maurice and The Miz is actually canon now, I'm not going to remake that match because that's not fun. I am going to use John Cena, though. And because he has granted so many make-a-wishes to children all across this great land of ours, I'm going to grant his make-a-wish.
Mm-hmm.
And we are going to have John Cena versus The Undertaker.
Playa. I like it. And I got to tell you, I'm personally offended that WWE refuses to make this match for WrestleMania.
Seriously. Is it leaving money on the table at that point?
You know,
I think they're waiting until Taker is sure it's going to be his last one.
I think they're waiting until he's dead.
So no one can believe when Cena wins? So
Larry,
wait.
He started as the dead man.
He is the dead man.
He's already dead. He can't get too much deader.
He's literally the WWE's dead horse.
Is he a zombie?
No.
Those wheels.
Now, Mad Mike, now it's time for you to delete someone from Mayhem Mania this year. Already deleted so far. This is good to remind everyone. Already deleted have been Ryback and Titus O'Neil. Thank so we're going to see who Mad Mike wants to delete. Mad Mike.
Oh, man. Matt Carlins. I've thought about this eliminator, and Fastlane only confirmed what I'm about to do. The Universal Champion Goldberg is deleted.
Oh no.
Yes.
Deleted. Son of a bitch.
Deleted.
Wow. Yes.
Because I want a match that lasts more than 30 seconds.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes.
That is not worth the $9.99.
I'm glad you reminded me, Mike, about that because last week and for about the last month or so, we've been hyping the Mayhem Mania Fastlane Challenge. We asked everyone to send in their guesses for how long the Owens-Goldberg match was going to go at Fastlane, Price is Right rules, closest without going over. Guess what? The lowest guess we got was a minute 20. It was 22 seconds long. Nobody freaking won. So you're all losers. I'm very disappointed in all of you. Where was the 1 second guess?
Yeah, nobody dollars.
The one nobody won right, sent that. Hold on. As I explained to you on Facebook, if someone guessed 1 second, the next person would have guessed 2 seconds.
So be
it. The person after that would have guessed 3 seconds.
Price is Right rules.
That's the way it goes.
But that's why no one guessed 1 second because we had hope.
I don't think
nobody wanted to be that guy.
No one was clamoring to guess a time that was less than a minute. We had people guessing like 10 minutes.
So are we doing that challenge for WrestleMania?
I don't know what reward we will hand out, but you know what? Maybe we should come up with something. Maybe we should give the owl away to this.
No, whoa.
Whoa.
That owl has been in my family since it was killed.
Well, how about How about Roman back then?
Roman? No, I don't know. Roman. Who wants Roman?
How about, no, let's give away Hulk's monkey.
I think you should give away the poster of the resurrection of Gavin Stone.
I will give that away.
Sorg, we'll see. If we can come up with a suitable prize, maybe we'll do that.
There you go.
What do we have left to do here? Oh, Mike. Mike, yeah. you must choose. Who will be forced to spin the wheel of 205 Live? And I will remind you that we have taken steps to ensure that Jack Gallagher and Austin Aries are not on the wheel. So they will not be be eligible to be the result on this wheel. But everyone else on the 205 Live roster, this came straight from the WWE.com website. So this is everyone, literally everyone else on the 205 Live roster is on this wheel. Who's going to get to spin it?
I don't bear any ill will toward Chad, Larry, or Wheelz. So what I'm going to do is there's a number. I'm thinking of a number between 1 and 10. All three of you have to guess a number. Whoever is closest gets punished.
All three of who?
Apparently Larry, Chad,
Larry, Wheelz, and Chad.
All right.
Yeah.
Go for it.
Yeah.
Number
9.
Okay.
Since I failed the Goldberg time thing, I'm going to say 1.
I'm going to say 2.
Oh. The number is 7.
7.
The number is 7. So I'm sorry. Chad
gets the punishment. Yep. All right.
I apologize. I apologize, Sir Spears, a lot.
Yeah.
Well, Chad, we'll spin the wheel once we get to your turn. You're batting cleanup. But Sorg, you're going first.
All right.
The usual options are in play. You can swap one for one wrestler out, bring another wrestler in, swap one wrestler to another match, bring the other wrestler to the other match, or do tag teams if that's applicable.
Well, I'll tell you what. You can also
kill a match entirely, create an entirely new one, or you can actually add an additional wrestler or tag team to a match to make it a three-way, four-way, something crazy, to the point where Tony Ogarza, who makes our graphics, starts to pull his hair out because an intergender mixed tag match is starting to look like a Dancing with the Stars promo. Sork, you're up.
Missy's all right, down. I'm going up and down this card, and I'm not really seeing much I don't hate out of this card. Like, there's not much that's really inspiring.
You don't see any room for improvement.
No, not much to inspire me to improve on or remove, except one of these things is not like the other. And and I want to know what Mike
leading the witness.
I could be talking about a couple of things going on, but one could be suits, one could be leather jackets. And given, and I hate to do this to front of the show, Jackson Argus, IWC Rookie of the Year. I think we're contractually obligated to say that every time.
I feel like we are.
As the guy that once retrieved ice cream from Eaton Park for Raven, I feel that I am the one that has the right to remove him from Mayhem Mania.
Just Raven?
We are getting rid of Raven. And I have an idea on who to replace him with, but I don't know. I'm looking up down the roster in my head, and I'm thinking if anybody's going to go at Bray, Shield's being used. Okay. If anybody's going to go at Bray, Braun's been used. I feel like it's too cliche to throw any other Wyatt or Orton at him. Let's give him Brock.
We can't. Brock's on the supercard.
Damn it, he was. Okay.
Who's left?
Not much. Brock versus Goldberg, I think, is our Hulk versus Andre.
You know what?
Bushwhacker.
Is Jericho anywhere on the board?
Nope.
Oh, yeah. Give me Jericho Wyatt all day long. Give me Sparkly Jacket against Dirty Jacket.
Write it in, man.
And Fireflies.
The list has spoken.
The list has spoken. You're right. Some creepy ass, like, the list versus, like, whatever the hell is in Bray's head these days.
Nothing. Randy burned it all out.
That's right. There you go. There you go.
All right, Missy, you're up. Larry, you're on deck.
Direct from off camera.
Yeah. I am not a fan of this Royce K versus Lay Cool match.
Yeah, I know.
What?
I should tell Chad that the reason that that match really even exists is because last week Mad Mike had to spin the wheel of women in NXT who are never ever going to beat Asuka. That was last week's punishment.
It was basically the NXT women law.
Basically the NXT
women. Okay, so that's how we wound up with that match. All right, that makes a little more sense now.
So it's some cleanup.
All right. Well, I'm going to add in a tag partner. You know what? No, I'm just going to take Royce and Kay out of that one.
Entirely. And keep play cool?
I'm going to keep play cool.
Wow. Okay, I'll accept that.
The Royce Kay was the part of it that I didn't like.
Okay.
So now I have to add in a tag match of ladies, or could be mixed.
I won't hold you to that.
Okay. Well, I'm
that's some sort of morality that other people are trying to hold their wrestling to. You won't find me doing that here.
Lucha Underground kind of blew it all up.
Have you seen Taya versus Cage?
Oh my god. Oh jeez.
Well, we have
Touché, Mike, touché.
We have a diva who has recently returned that I would like to add into this.
Are you making a match for me?
Emma's not back yet.
No.
Which is coming very soon.
Mickey James.
Emelina's back.
That's one. Doing this handicap.
Mickey James.
And I kind of want to see her tag with a Trish Stratus.
Trish is pregnant.
Ah, damn it.
Damn. Physical and mental.
Missy, otherwise I would have made Trish and Lita last week.
Yeah, I was considering Trish and Lita, to be honest. And I was like, no, I don't want to do Trish and Lita. I'll go ahead and throw somebody else in there. All right. We will go with a Mickey and...
We're struggling to find good women to put in these matches.
You could rhyme. You could go the rhyming route. Mickey and Nikki.
And then, no, I'm...
No, you're not.
Definitely not.
You're an honorary Bella twin.
She audibly...
Hey, Matt.
Dana Brooke. She's kind of like Trish Stratus.
Matt, our Hall of Famers off the board.
Or Ember Moon.
Yeah, are Hall of Famers off the board?
Not really. If they can go, they can
Unless they're injured.
Let's throw in Beth Phoenix.
I can do that.
All right.
Is she pregnant?
Mickey and Beth.
Not lately. Not lately. No.
You're not like cool.
I missed that whole time. Wait, Chad. Is Beth pregnant?
No.
Okay.
Not lately.
Not lately.
Let me text.
Not lately. Yeah, let me ask you. I believe we only have one child.
No, he's doing the math from the last time that things would have happened.
Hang on. Hall of Fame right. Schedule is. Wheelz,
you're on deck. Yeah,
I love how we just straight up have a match from 2008 now.
I know. The WWE Women's main roster has never been this strong, and we're pulling old names from like 10 years ago.
Okay. We talked on Sunday about the lack of Hardys being used. Are they safe still?
Mm-hmm. Well, not really. I mean,
under contract?
For a week there, they were out there, and then they signed with Ring of Honor.
But is that...
We don't know how long the Ring of Honor contract lasts. We don't know if it runs out at WrestleMania.
Is it the anniversary show in a few weeks? You know?
I mean, we know that they're sort of signed, but sort of...
This requires research.
All right. I defer... Can I pass my pick on... Or wait till the end, or because I don't want to make
this will only take a minute to check.
I mean, okay, I'll wait. I'm
trying to Well, let's talk about how much we love the Hardy Boys. You know,
they're so Hardy in
because I have a good one this week.
Okay. Well, can he announce his prospective match while we're checking on the legalities of it?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Talk about that.
If you're allowed, what would you do?
If I'm allowed, yes. I would like to get rid of Braun.
Okay.
And put Samoa Joe versus the Hardys.
Both of
them.
Well,
the Destroyer.
Because I feel like that's something Impact would have never thought of.
I kind of like it.
I think.
Well, I mean, they would have, but it would have involved a van kidnapping.
Wait, would somebody been hit by a van?
No, unfortunately not.
No, Samoa Joe was kidnapped by ninjas.
Only our common sense.
Larry, you're in trouble. Because what I'm looking at right here is that the deal that they have with Ring of Honor is running at least through May. So that takes the metaphor.
All right.
So for a week, they're out there. So you guys, y'all missed your chance.
Keep that match for SummerSlam Mania.
Riz really blew it.
Riz really blew it.
Damn it, Riz.
All right.
Delightful. And here's another question. Why would you take Braun Strowman off the card? The internet's favorite wrestler.
We can find another.
Just see that match on Sunday.
I mean, I know I slept through it the first time,
but I went up and I watched it again. I would watch you sleep through Raw. I'm sorry, I fell asleep during Fastlane.
I'm pretty sure if we ask the entire internet if they like more Braun Strowman or Matt Hardy, that's going to come up Matt Hardy.
Yeah, yeah.
You're probably.
I knew they'd say that. On
a Big Show again.
Man.
That match was awesome, though.
All right. Mm-hmm.
They should have had that Roman Reigns Braun Strowman match. They should have done that match at WrestleMania. Mm-hmm. That match, that exact same match in front of 50,000 more people, would have been absolutely bananas. Would have blown there isn't going to be a roof. It would have made a very loud sound. Off. It would have blown it already the cloud off. Cover off of the Camping Life Stadium.
Okay, here. This is what I'm going to do. I'm sorry, Missy. We're getting rid of Gentleman Jack.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Oh, no.
For regular Jack.
Shouldn't anger the producers.
Regular Jack.
Cut off
Mike. Jack Daniels.
Jack Swagger.
It's just the bottle. Actually, he's gone.
He just got rid of him.
They just got rid of him.
I mean, they could bring him back.
I can't wait for him to pop up with Zeb again in TNA.
Gosh. Oh, no. Swagger technically isn't released yet.
Oh, okay. But, you know, eventually.
He only asked for his release, so Jack Swagger is still
on. And they said, no, damn it, you're working WrestleMania. I don't.
You're gonna be an
you're
extra
gonna get
on the
thrown
stage.
Out in the Andre Bell role, and you're gonna fucking like it, Jack.
I feel like Wade did the same thing, but anyways,
Demon Kane.
Demon Kane versus Demon Balor.
Right. Okay.
Oh, the pyro and the theatrics.
Oh. Your wife would be so scared.
Oh yeah, I know that'll scare her. But you know what? Jericho's pyro scares her too. So.
I'm really disappointed that I had to make that. But...
Yeah, that's all right. I mean, that's
I love
good.
You, Jen.
Can we put Kane in his outfit from See No Evil?
Oh, jeez. Or See No Evil or See No Evil 2.
Either or. He pulled out that hook at a WrestleMania once.
He did. He did.
Yeah, against Great Khali of all people.
He did.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I must have skipped that one. Wheelz, you're up.
I don't blame you.
Chad, you're on deck.
All right. Let's see. I'm an evil, sadistic person. I just want to see the enjoyment. Besides me doing it on the video game. So I want to put James Ellsworth in the match with Strowman.
You went up.
And make it a triple.
Didn't I?
And make it a triple threat.
All right. Excellent. I am all about that. Anywhere we can get Ellsworth on his card. What
the hell was he wearing tonight?
Oh, by the way,
I know, right?
Didn't Alexa call Cena the square chin Superman tonight?
Yes, yep. She did.
That was fucking amazing.
I know. She got her shot in while he wasn't around. That's the way to do
Alexa Bliss is fucking killing it, you guys.
Yes, absolutely.
JBL had me dying tonight also, just with his comments towards Ellsworth.
Didn't he call him not human at some point?
Well, that's
he said he was like a turtle with no shell.
He's been saying that for a month.
Yeah.
Isn't that just Mitch McConnell?
Ellsworth is...
Oh.
The younger version.
Hashtag BMS.
Got a hell of a promo. All right. Well, Chad, it is time for you to have a wrestler forced upon you.
Oh,
I hate to see this happen to a newcomer, but...
So, hold on. Let
me cue this. Chad, I'm sorry. It's the luck of the draw.
Sorg, please bring up the wheel of 205 Live.
Tell your sister hi, Mike.
Are you ready?
And give it a spin.
It's not spinning.
It will. It will. It will. It's a little bit of delay. It's okay. I know the answer.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Who's that? Who's that?
And it's...
Grandmata League! Oh, very nice. Bad. Or as Tonio Garza called him last night, Grandmata League.
Is that what he called him?
Something like that.
Are you sure about that?
I'll have to get him. I'll have to check out last week's episode of Talking Mayhem Mania to see how Garza exactly said it. But he made it sound amazing.
I'm pretty sure. I don't feel like I'm capable of doing that.
All right. Gran Metalik, or as we call him in the States, Gran Metalik.
Okay. So that's who I have to work with.
Huh? I feel like that's a paint color at Michael's.
Doesn't really matter what you do. You just have to use Gran Metalik.
Okay.
Then he can be a replacement, or...
Throw him in. You could create a match with him.
He's the only one I have. I
he's the only one you have to use.
That's it. Can I add anybody else to it?
Sure.
As well.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see here.
Yeah. Please feel free to explore the boundaries of the, you know, vague rules that we set up for this whole operation.
Take it to the limit.
Yes, exactly.
This whole operation, I picture one of those, like, monkeys with a symbol as the operation.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's see here.
While Chad's thinking this over, I want to properly promote that after you get done watching the Mayhem Show, you should definitely go and check out Talking Mayhem Mania. The hottest damn new show on the internet. The hottest 10 minutes of internet content you'll find all week. And we will talk about Mayhem Mania. And I'm not sure what we're going to talk about this week because I'm not sure what we're going to talk about. We're going to think
well, because here's, great. Here's my thing as far as let's talking Mayhem Mania is concerned. Renee is talking about the Talking Smack and that we have to wait for some content.
Yeah. We should start an internet feud. Stay tuned for Talking Mayhem Mania when we will attempt to start a Twitter feud with Nene. It's going to be great fun without using Dean Ambrose. That's a challenge. We're going to challenge ourselves. Got to keep a high bar.
What are we going to do? Way to be Canadian?
Dean was almost killed by a forklift tonight.
Yeah, that's true.
She has some awful hats.
I'm going to make a splash.
Do not. Okay?
I'm going to make a splash.
Oh, he's got it. He's got it.
Are you ready?
All right, got it.
We're going to turn this into a grand match.
A grand match, yes.
Nah,
grand,
I see what you did there. Match.
Make it big.
So
go big.
Take Styles and Nakamura.
Oh.
And add Grand.
All right.
And add Johnny Gargano.
I can't let you do that.
No.
I can't let you do that.
It's only one. One for
only one.
Yep. Now, if you want to create an entirely new match, you can bring in Grand. You can bring in Johnny. If you got anyone else in mind, we can do that. But we're going to just add. I can only let you add one.
Okay.
You got someone else in mind? We could go three-way tag team match.
Or you could do a tag team.
Yeah.
Grand Metalik and Johnny Gargano. Wait,
would that be a...
Mm-hmm. Or DIY versus Grand Metalik.
If you add another three-way into that other three-way dance there.
Yeah, we can add another three guys.
Would that be a cube match?
This
that's,
one?
Yes.
That's what we're
only
do.
Up to a triangle on this one.
Grand and DIY.
But Grand and DIY added to the TNA Dream match?
Yeah.
Excellent. I love it.
Yeah.
Excellent. I'm a big fan.
Nice twist. I like
that's
that.
That's nine men in this match.
Yes.
Tonio's head's going
to
explode.
They're going to have to reinforce
it's
the ring.
Match.
They're going to have to
all these cruisers, how can we hold them all?
They're going to have to reinforce Garza's Photoshop.
There's a crazy mishmash of skill in that match.
Garza is hating us.
No, he's happy because
we should add a new Triost. Every week we add a new trio.
Well, that's good because I was starting to be a little sad that DIY wasn't on this card. I thought everyone loved DIY.
I get a friend of the show, Johnny Gargano.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah.
There's a lot of guys that you guys have been neglecting, and I'm a little. We can do better. But,
we forget about NXT sometimes.
I've decided that my pick for next week, if I'm allowed back, is going to be Tom Phillips.
That dirty
get dirty? He's going into the Samoa Joe match.
Oh, calling his shots. Because we have some people in the chat room that have been saying what they would do if they were
it's
on.
Coming.
Yeah.
Brandon, and you know, Brandon has been commenting on the videos and the Talking Mayhem Mania lately.
Mm-hmm. We love Brandon.
He said he would like to see Kill Styles and versus Nakamura. And add Orton versus Corbin.
Right?
There you go.
Not too bad.
The Battle of the Weird Abdominals.
What?
Orton versus Corbin. Look at that.
I want you to explain what's wrong with Orton's core.
I'm just saying. I've watched a lot of Randy Orton matches.
Okay.
It's just a little off-putting. That's all.
Okay.
Okay.
That's all.
By the way, tonight him missing and out of nowhere.
Oh.
Did he?
When AJ Styles just jumped up, that's probably the greatest spot in 2017.
Yes, absolutely.
It was pretty solid.
That was cool.
It was.
Let me recap.
It ended up not mattering because we're going to see a fucking Shane McMahon match, but...
he could get injured.
Mayhem Mania wrapping up right now.
Let me wrap this up so we can take it home, Sorg. Samoa Joe versus Braun Strowman versus...
I'm already home.
I'm not going home.
Well...
let's do it so Chad can go home.
Okay.
I'm coming home.
Samoa Joe versus Braun Strowman versus James Ellsworth. Chris Jericho versus Bray Wyatt. AJ Styles versus Shinsuke Nakamura. Demon Kane versus Demon Finn Balor. What is now a three-way triangle... It's fucked up.
It's a Triforce match.
Triforce match.
It is a pyramidal prism match.
Bobby Roode, Austin Aries, and Eric Young versus Booker T, Scott Steiner, and Kurt Angle versus Grand Metalik and DIY. Mickey James and Beth Phoenix versus Lay Cool. Charlotte versus Asuka and John Cena versus The Undertaker in the Make-A-Wish match. let me remind everybody. I don't know what The Undertaker's wish is, but he'll get it if he wins.
Brought to you by Impact Snowpiece.
He gets to retire. That's his wish.
Sorg, friendly reminder. Yes. Someone asked me on Twitter today, so I figure it's a good time to get this out there. Patreon in the bank round is going to be on Tuesday, March 21st. If you want to play in the Patreon in the bank round, you must pay. You must be a Patreon supporter of the Wrestling Mayhem Show and Sorgatron Media. And you who are brought in, the Patreons, will be granted godlike powers beyond what the normal moves are to wreak havoc and cause all sorts of fun with the Mayhem Mania card. We're talking stipulations. We're talking all sorts of crazy stuff. So it's going to be good times.
Matt, what's up? As someone who has done Patreon on the bank for the past 2 years,
mm-hmm.
for a dollar, you can do any fucking thing you want.
Yeah.
If Matt might even let you raise people from the dead. He might. I'm not sure. I can't confirm or deny.
You have these magical powers?
Is it true? You said godlike.
There's
powers.
A shrug. There's a shrug.
To find out.
There's a shrug for the audio, by the way.
I mean, like, godlike. Not god powers. Godlike. As if you were, a god, but not completely.
Finger
like.
Quotes for those on audio.
Yeah, you know, Neo brought someone back to life. Come on.
I didn't say Matrix-like powers.
It's okay. Anyways.
Here's my question. In the grand scheme of shows such as TNA or such as Lucha Underground, would a return from the death be unrealistic?
Absolutely
people
not.
People have a tendency to actually stay dead on Lucha Underground, so...
People have come back from being mounted on somebody's wall. I just saw. So.
It does kind of depend on how in touch with the dark side you are, according to Vampiro.
Yes.
You know, if you're down with the dark side, you know, perhaps you can come back. If not, then you get eaten and you're gone. So
wait, does being down with the dark side involve Vampiro telling you to eat a bag of dicks? Because then I'm down with the dark side.
Wait, what?
Wait, is Mad Mike saying he was eating a bag of dicks?
That was your...
I'm saying Vampiro has told me to eat a bag of dicks. Right.
It's
the nicest thing he ever said to us.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, it is.
We did take it as a compliment.
I would.
Being friends with me means you're down with the dark side.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. I like it. Okay.
Brother.
Yeah.
Wow.
So still, clear as mud.
What in the world did you guys learn from wrestling this week? What did you learn from wrestling this week?
I'm just reading Bobby's what he learned.
Yes, Matt Carlin's.
I learned that what we consider a good guy and a bad guy in wrestling is really weird. Kevin Owens deceives and uses Chris Jericho, makes him think he's his best friend for months and months and months, turns on him, he's a bad guy. Mm-hmm. Randy Orton becomes friends with Bray Wyatt months and months and months, burns down his house, he's a good guy. I mean, is that weird to anybody else?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. But then he posed in front of the burning house, and I was like, he's cool.
That the pose makes it okay.
The pose made it okay.
Arson is cool now.
Arson, John, Randy Arson, everybody.
Missy?
Randy Arson, yes. I learned that wrestling, such as the stylings of Lucha Underground story, is so over that it is on Fuller House.
Oh, yes.
Sorg and I watched.
Missy gets up and she's been watching Fuller House on Netflix for her workouts. And I'm on a different sleep schedule than she is, so I'm sleeping when this happens. She comes in. She brings the iPad with her and she says, "You gotta watch this with me." I'm like, "What's happening?" She's like, "We're watching Fuller House." I'm like, "Why do you hate me?"
this is a legit conversation we had this morning.
We've established.
I was very excited about Fuller House when it first came out, and I knew, and I remember this was mentioned to me, but maybe by you, Mike, or somebody, that this was something that was coming up, and there was a Lucha episode, and they went and saw Lucha Kaboom. Kaboom, not Vavoom. I was excited for a moment. I'm like, oh, okay. I mean, yeah, watch it. Yeah, watch it. it's wrestling. Not as good. I will say not as good as the Family Matters episode with the wrestling. What was it?
Boy Meets World with Vader.
What?
Boy Meets World with Vader.
No, there was a Family Matters episode where Urkel and the dad got in a match with, was it the Bushwhackers, maybe?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah, that...
Oh,
that.
Wow. Oh my God, are they eligible for the Mayhem Mania?
The Bushwhackers?
Yeah.
Did you see the Hall of Fame last year?
Their
hearts are beating.
A lot of guys' hearts are beating.
We thought that one guy was going to take a off the stage, but when he was bushwhacking with his cane.
That was a gimmick.
I really thought you were going to say Urkel and the other guy.
No, if Urkel and Carl Winslow are eligible for Mayhem Mania, I'm changing my fucking match right now.
This is true.
all moves are permanent. You can't go back and change it later.
Damn it! I want to put them against the Fashion Police!
Here's my statement as far as any of that's concerned, Sorg. Was the wrestling that you watched this morning on Fuller House still better than Impact?
That's a tough one. That is a tough one.
Yes.
It's like, once again, as Mad Mike usually says, it's not the wrestling that's the problem, it's the story around it. But what'd you learn, Chad the Shad?
I learned that we may be in something may be happening that we do not fully appreciate as we are seeing it real time. And that is the greatness that is Chris Jericho. I don't think we are truly appreciative of what he is doing and how he goes about his business. I think it'll be years later we'll look back and go, wow, he had it all. Because I really think he's at the top of his game. And he's been at the top of his game for a while, but I think we just kind of expect that and we're just living through it.
It's a guy that goes away and then ends up on the top of the card and on freaking pay-per-view posters and then goes away.
Yeah.
Then comes back and we're like, this is weird. Oh, like there's a ride.
He can do anything with anyone in any outcome.
Right.
And, I mean, he made a clipboard get over. He comes up, he has brand new catchphrases every time. Mm-hmm. He never wears himself too thin with even moves.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the code breaker and all that. He's a genius. I mean, I don't know how he sleeps either. I have no idea.
Mm-hmm. Does that man look like he sleeps?
I mean, the thing is, he still looks... doesn't look like he's, you know, hurting for rest.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. I think he's a... I don't think we're truly appreciating him as well as we maybe should have. And I think that goes with a lot of different things in life. And, you know, a couple years down the road, we'll look back and go, man, Jericho, running a band... wrestling,
but I drink
doing podcasts.
The biggest thing is I was watching the Unfiltered with Renee Young with him a couple weeks ago. And they're like, so you know, you did had the dream of the band and you had the dream of the wrestling. You know, did you ever, you know, have to say, I got to pick one? He's like, no, I've always gone full stream with both dreams.
Yeah.
And that's like, oh, wow. You know, he did.
And he has a podcast that he continuously pumps out with good content.
Yeah.
With crazy guests.
Right, right.
Anyway, how do you find the time to coordinate?
A little bit of an acting career, too. And have you listened to a lot of Fozzie?
I've tried.
You've tried.
Some of it is...
Okay.
Is not bad.
I've dropped the Fozzie, like, hey, play me everything Fozzie on Google Music. And I'm just like, wow, this is not what I expected.
Yeah.
And it was pretty good. Right?
Some of it's not exactly my cup of tea, but right. That doesn't take away the fact that others...
Yeah,
take it. I'm not gonna.
But it's a variety.
Some of it is. I'm like, wow, that's.
But it's
okay.
Also
that's
a variety too, yeah. Right? Like, it's not just like the '80s covers that they started with. Like, it gets like less '80s rocky kind of thing.
He's matured as a musician.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
As well as he has matured as a wrestler.
Yeah, and they're big. They're touring worldwide.
Yeah,
you know, so doing very very well.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. Larry.
Buck Goldberg.
Okay. All right.
That's all.
Mike.
Hi, Sorg. I learned Jerry Lawler should never be allowed to do commentary ever again.
Again, we discussed this on the Raw wrap up.
No, but it needs to be restated.
Okay, you claim that Jerry Lawler is single-handedly the reason why the Divas division was so bad for so many years.
I'm not saying the reason why it was so bad. A lot of that has to do with talent. I'm saying it's the reason it was never taken seriously.
Okay.
Because there was in my 32 Manias with Mike series that I'm doing. There was a match with Trish, Victoria, and Jazz, and it was fucking awesome. And all Jerry Lawler could do was talk about how he wouldn't fuck Jazz, and he was staring at Trish's tits. That's the reason this shit was never taken seriously.
Mm-hmm. But Mike, you forgot to do the voice.
No, I'm not doing the voice again because my throat hurts from doing the voice last night. But no, like,
if you want to hear the voice, go check out the Raw wrap up.
Sorg, I'll even go so far as Jerry Lawler should never be able to have a conversation with a woman again. Because he clearly doesn't know how to converse. Like,
it's like he's got a social problem, like a different kind of social problem.
A lot of people these days have a social problem like
well.
That. But yeah, no, it's just, it's horrible. It's absolutely horrible. And the reason it's so bad is because people listen to him and people think his views are accurate because he's quote unquote the funny one. Like, it's just bad. It's awful. Like, Corey Graves right now is doing the Lord's work when it comes to like Charlotte.
Yes.
I'm serious. No, like, he is praising Charlotte for being like the epitome of wrestling, and it's fucking perfect.
Absolutely.
And even when he would talk about Eva Marie, he was putting Eva Marie over in a way that wasn't just about her looks, which is great.
Exactly. And you know, she couldn't wrestle her way out of a paper bag, but still.
Immaterial.
Wheelz, how about you? What'd you learn?
What did I learn? I learned for their first match together tonight, I really want to see another AJ Orton match as a main event because, I mean, those two worked very well together tonight.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And from the chat room here, live.wrestlingmayhemshow.com and the Facebook live page, Bobby F. J-Town learned that his favorite wrestler returned tonight on SmackDown, Forklift.
Forklift once won the WWE title.
That's true. That's true. Also, Brandon learned that Maurice still can't wrestle. Did she wrestle tonight? This week?
She pushed
Maggie Bella
into a trash compactor. Please,
No.
Damn it.
No. All right, guys. Thank you so much. And let us know what you learned on the Facebook, on the Twitter. Whatever you would like to. Thank you, Chad the Shad, for returning the show.
Thank you for having me.
Please, don't be a stranger. Anytime.
Maybe I'll come back next week. Sure. I enjoyed Mayhem Mania.
There you go.
Maybe not. It wouldn't be the only reason I'm coming back. But
well, the owl will still be here.
This owl better be gone. Or I'll make it gone.
That son of a bitch owl. Oh. Everywhere.
Oh. Live I'll on put it in a figure four leg lock. Edge knows a figure four leg lock.
Yes.
So
does he?
Yes, he does. You learn it anytime you touch Ric Flair in any sort of submission by osmosis. You just learn things.
Yes.
That's how Charlotte knows how to spear. Got passed down.
Okay.
From Ric Flair?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because mm-hmm. when Ric Flair fought Edge became Ric Flair on the side of a road.
That's right.
The only thing you can pick
That's
up.
That's right.
That is some hell of a kayfabe right there. I mean, I'm bringing right. it all around.
Every 6 degrees of separation.
Can you explain why the music plays every time the wrestler comes through the entrance ramp when they're not supposed to be there?
Audio. That's Goldberg getting slammed in, or that's Goldust getting slammed into the big box in the back, right?
Getting electrocuted.
Yeah, and then it just sets off the soundboard.
I feel like in my mind when that happens, like Kevin Owens comes out or Samoa Joe came out and attacked Sammy and was music played. I feel like he's just they're storming in from wherever they were, hearing the promo that just pissed them off, and they're just pointing and yelling at the sound guy right at the gorilla. Play my shit! I'm going out.
I have an idea.
I know that feeling.
All right, when you sign to wrestle with WWE, you have to get officially licensed footwear, okay? Each piece of footwear has a transponder in it, okay? And there's a scanner thing in the gorilla.
It's like
when you walk through, the transponder picks up on the thing in your foot and automatically plays your music. That's why when you come in through the crowd, the music doesn't play.
It's all about RFID tags, right. Man. It's all about the technology. Mutilator Larry on the Twitter. Loves 205 Live.
It's the only thing good on TV right now.
But it's not even on TV. It's not even TV. It's on your phone, dude.
It's on my phone. It's the only thing good on my phone right now.
Mad Mike, Poughkeepsie, New York, American yes. Kevin Owens.
And please check out 32 Manias of Mike. We are on WrestleMania 6 today, Sorg.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's a lot of fun. I'm almost done recording the rest of them, but there are some. We may have a special segment coming up after WrestleMania this year about WrestleMania.
Well, okay. All right.
Spoilers. Sorg, you know about this.
And also, if you want to check out the 32 Manias with Mike, you can check out the Wrestling Mayhem Show Super Feed that's on iTunes, Stitcher, and Google Play. Also keep an eye, we are moving that feed, so if the shows may stop coming to you in the next week, please resubscribe or hit the links over at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Moving a lot of our stuff over to Fireside.fm, been some really great to us in our moves from Awesome Cast and the main Wrestling Mayhem Show feed moved a little bit ago as well. I don't know if I've completed that and let you guys know that, but it has been. I hope it's been faster. But anyways, except for when Amazon's down. Matt Carlin's Mainstream Matt on the Twitters.
Don't miss Talking Mayhem Mania. I will confront Mad Mike about something that's been troubling me for a couple of weeks.
Uh-oh. Oh, there it goes.
Surprise.
Oh. And then off camera, of course, producer of the show, wife of the show, Missy.
Oh, I'm making magic over here.
Oh, some stuff's happening. I bet it's going to be the album art, isn't it?
Yes.
It's going to be show art.
Strowman fan art.
It's been amazing. It's probably been her.
Is it Impact Snow Peas?
Oh.
I guess you'll have to see.
Because you have to see. Oh, Wheelz, RWALive.com. He's a sound guy over there. Please go check him out and check out the wrestling that's around there, too.
Yes, yes. Check everything out that you can. I mean, hey, I'm a man of many trades, so. Keep an eye out. You'll see me anywhere.
Steel cage match, March 25th, between Mempho Mofo and Chris Taylor, yes. Both friends of the show here on the Wrestling Mayhem Show. So please check that out. And also in wrestling news, right there behind Mutilator Larry is the IWC 16 poster. Wardlow and DJ Z. As well as plenty of friends of the show returning, including Dylan Bostic, Gorian Fasada as Flippin' Ain't Easy, and Shug D he's going by? The former Sugar Dunkerton is returning there March 11th here in Pittsburgh. And of course, both those shows, RWA, IWC, will be available on indiewrestling.us. Support the show through there. And of course, the Link Fight TV, patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. And if you found us any other way or wanted it a different way, subscribe to us on iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, and video versions on the YouTube or Facebook page, live.wrestlingmayhemshow.com. Remember, we'll be on Wednesday with our special guest,
Chris DeJosa from Lucha Underground.
We'll be on part of the main Wrestling Mayhem show.
And he is going to be a part of Mayhem Mania, too. He is very excited.
He dropped some bombs last year on Mayhem Mania, right?
Yes.
Yes, last year he came on and played Mayhem Mania. He created the perfect Mayhem Mania match, and we screwed it up a week later.
So we'll see if we can get better by bringing him a little later in the game this time. So looking forward to that. So we'll see you on a Wednesday Wrestling Mayhem. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. Thank you so much to the chat room, Brandon. What's the other guy's name?
Billy.
It was like not Brian. Billy and Tina, and so many more dropping in through the night. Thank you so much for being a part of the show. Couldn't do it without you guys. We'll see you guys next time. Mayhem out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.